I feel like I'm following in your footsteps in a lot of ways.
Whether you like it or not.
You know, living in Hartford on that same street, going to UConn later in life.
And I was number three in my family, and you're number three.
That's true.
And you weighed the same.
We weighed the same?
As I did when I was born.
Didn't know that. And now I'm living 2 miles away from you in Manchester, Connecticut. Like, I don't know if it's just the way the universe has worked or if I just know I really want to be close to you.
Maybe it's both.
Yeah, I think it can be. I wanted to talk to you about where you were when you were my age, when you were 31. I know you had had Greg at that time. Peter was on the way.
He was a baby.
A baby.
Yeah.
What were the things in life that were most on your mind?
Motherhood pretty much consumed me. With a two-year-old and an infant, it was just centered around keeping the family going and the day-to-day activities of having two small kids.
Yeah. Do you ever think about that time and wish that you had more spent more time on yourself or for yourself? Or
no, I have no regrets.
I think as I'm in this point of looking ahead to the family that, you know, Brendan and I hope to have and how I hope to have a career that fulfills me. And, you know, there's that question of, you know, how can I successfully put my needs and my dreams at the forefront as well as my family? And I feel really fortunate to have a partner who's cheering me on every step of the way and would love to be a stay-at-home dad. Like, you know, that feels really wonderful. And I see you like work tirelessly for other people, and really hasn't been until I got to this age where I see my friends have kids, and this is so hard. Like, being a mom is so hard. Just witnessing you, I don't know, do it all so gracefully and also own your own business and be your own boss. And I just want to say, like, I think you've done it all, like, really beautifully. And I'm like, oh, that seems difficult. And so I guess I want to know, like, what, knowing me and my personality and the way in which I sometimes let my emotion overrun, what do you hope for me and for Brendan and our family as we take that next step, if we're lucky enough to do so?
Well, I really hope that you find a way to blend your career goals with a family. And I think you can do that because you've always, your whole life, taken on a full plate, and you've always handled it. And I think with Brendan, you'll be fine in achieving that.
I hope that you know that I admire you so much, and that's why I wanted to talk with you today. You have lived a really rich life and have taught me so much about how to be a great person. And I just want to say thank you, because you have been that constant support.
You don't have to thank me. I feel
but
it.
But I will.
Okay. I accept. Thank you for being such a wonderful, wonderful person.
I love you, Mom.
I love you, Andrea.